yield to none.
Then let him burn.
Resurrected.
Prepare yourself. Prepare yourself.
Meet your maker.
A single rage-wrought thought rolls from the dead lizard's spirit. Those magister bastards. You are a spy at the consulate when a source at the Paladins delivers a bombshell. News of a magister black ring conspiracy. When the Voidwoken come, you believe it is part of a dark magister plot. You see a party of nobles racing from the Voidwoken onslaught. Among them, a comely lizard, scales of red. They don't run away from the consulate, but further inward.
Hatter didn't escape. Then she must still be inside.
glory is mine!
To none! the reaper for me.
The spirit turns her gaze upon you. Her eyes blaze with cruel disdain. Alert and focused, this spirit is not lost. Not lost at all. She tilts her head, resisting your intrusion. No sooner do you catch hold of a memory than she snatches it back again. Voidwoken attacking. A rush to protect the dreamers. A death as the dreamers escape. The spirit resists. She bombards you with memories of everything but the dreamers and to where they escaped. Visions of life at the consulate assail you. The taste of the food at official receptions, the laughter of children playing out in the gardens, the warm sun on your skin as you walk by the water, the burgeoning sadness as you realize that life is dead. The bombardment stops. The image of you as divine hangs between you, and then the spirit smiles. The vision appears. The dream is escaping out through the garden and into a pool. A figure accompanies them, an elegant female kin with the reddest of skin.
Under lock and key.
Heavy bone jaws emerge from the heart of this breastplate. Looking into the open mouth is dizzying. Ash and a warm red mist surround you. A memory flashes, and you're far from home. The city has no lizard architecture save the building in front of you. Seeing a piece of your heritage is grounding. Heat envelops you from head to toe as a guttural voice rumbles in your ear. It snuffs out the memory with its first breath.
I see you. And inside you is the strength I've been looking for. Find the place where the Dreamer discovered her people. I will draw strength from there to speak again.
That longing re-emerges with twice the strength. You need that beam of hope, an anchor to home. As the feeling dissipates, a cold sensation slips down your spine. Something otherworldly lingers behind you.
I've spotted something. A mysterious portal to an unknown destiny. How whimsical. Onward, then. The garden. Is unscathed.
Sadness grips you at the sight of the ruined lizard consulate. So much has been lost. The sky burns red, and ash falls at your feet. Ruin calls to ruin.
Her people were severed in twain. No matter her visions, a dream of peace would never come true. I said it would be so.
Invisible force staggers you, shoving you like a mob on all sides. It wants you beaten down, brought to heel. With the push of raw willpower, you deny that force. It has no hold on you, and never will.
I am the Devourer. I cannot be defied. Speak to the Dreamer. Ensure she brings you to me, and you shall see the true scope of my power.
The vision is banished, and your next breath is free from ash. An invisible presence awaits your attention. An imperious, elegant woman.
What are you looking at?
I must hear the voice of my finest.
Close.
I hear its song. Perfection must be my.
A lizard in heavy ritual garb stands before you, awaiting your attention.
Ah, the fractured empire. I thank you for showing me what remains. The cruelty of my kin must be undone to honor its memory.
The Dreamer returns your bow and offers a faint smile.
Perhaps my honor is all that survives. Let us speak of present matters. That of the outlaw Empress in her misguided quest to claim the Devourer's power. She wished to overcome the true Emperor and sought the dragon's bones to make armor that could channel the beast. It made her into a monster. She was already prone to brutality, but the voice of the Devourer bid her to rip soul from flesh. Now our spirits are bound to this armor. We cannot escape without your aid. This cannot continue. The Devourer seeks to ascend by claiming a champion who will feast on the ones bound to this set. I beg of you, with utmost humility, you must prevent his rise. No matter the cost. That shall not be an easy task. Confronting the Devourer could claim your life. The dragon's dream sleeps within the armor. I can lead you to this dream to destroy the Devourer's essence. But until he dies, you will be locked in the Hall of Echoes. I am not strong enough to free you alone.
The other spirits watch you, wary and unable to hide their interest.
Will you confront the Devourer and set us free?
The Dreamer's disappointment is palpable, but she is more resigned than surprised.
I bow to your will. I bow to the dream. But the Devourer's true form may twist your mind anew.
The Dreamer watches you.
May I be of assistance?
Zol Stissa, the lizard god. The artist has certainly captured her arrogance.
The spirit howls in excruciating agony, trapped in the moment of her death. The Voidwoken are attacking, the dreamers are escaping, and she is burning alive. Your touch draws her out of the endless pain. The Voidwoken are gone. The dreamers have escaped through the pond. And although she still trembles, a new look has appeared in her eyes. Hope. She embraces you in gratitude, sobbing in relief. As the tears flow, her spirit dissolves in your arms, and she leaves for the Hall of Echoes.
I've spotted something.
Lucky find.
The spirit doesn't speak, but instead stretches his arm backward, an unseen weapon clasped in his ghostly fist, and moves to strike. The lizard is not of flesh, yet you are sure you feel the edge of a blade as it sinks into your chest. In an instant, you are no longer you, but him, crouched low and concealed in shadow. Panic shouts ring through the air, but you must not allow yourself to be distracted. Your eyes remain on your quarry, a female lizard, scales burning red, clad in opulent garb. You remain 20 silent steps behind her as she flees into the consulate garden, where a shimmering portal of opal and pearl illuminates the pool beneath. Finally, the opportunity has come. She is as good as dead. You flit into a cluster of tall shrubs and ready your dagger. But she has already stepped through the portal, leaving you alone in this unlikely oasis. Alas, you will never know. Nor will you know whose sword it was that plunged into your back in that moment. It isn't the blade's pain that hurts most, but the pain of the failed assassination that most disturbs you as you slip into darkness. And the pain is gone. You are you again. The spirit drops his arm to his side, dejected. You see billows of golden sand stretching beyond the walls and wells that roll across the portal's surface. It isn't clear if the portal allows return travel, but you're inclined to doubt it. You've heard of such portals. They are rare creations of the House of Dreams, leading to planes where dreams manifest as reality. You've never seen one yourself, however, until now. Looking closer, you notice a spot of red through the swirling sand, and you hear a voice. She sings. She beckons.
Horror sleep. There must be dreamers close by. Be careful. Death here is death in real life, too.
Good evening, Godwoken. I trust you sleep well. I am here to tell you the truth, the terrible deep down truth, the inescapable deep down truth. You are here for the truth, the terrible truth, the inescapable truth. That you are not enough. You have never been enough. You will never be enough. You are not enough. You were never enough. You will never be enough. Come face the truth. Come face up to your lies. You are not enough!
The glass in the mirrors shimmers and tears. Reality shifts. Apparitions take shape, and they seem familiar.
Enough.
wanted to give the water captain a thumb.
Nightmares in that mirror.
Here you die, but we do not. You may break one.
It's time to meet an old friend. Come, my prince.
Face the you are not enough. You were never enough.